This is the newest show at Image City Photography Gallery, and here to talk to us is one of our guest photographers, Dick Thomas.
So tell me, what are you doing this month? What's your plan? I saw you submitted that photo of, I believe that's a black and white of Letchworth, if I'm not mistaken.
It is. It's got a little bit of a sepia tone to it. I thought that I would do black and white this month, you know, black metal frame. It's a little bit a deviation. I did a black and white show with you folks one time. I, like everybody else, likes to experiment with black and white, and I've gotten more and more serious about it lately. And I thought this upcoming show would be a good time to have some fun and try to produce some images. I have to be honest with you. I have a bunch of them lined up here that I haven't even converted yet that I want to see just what I can do and see what kind of results I can get. As I've probably mentioned before, these opportunities that I have at Image City Photography Gallery, I take them on not just as an opportunity to show some of my work, but as an opportunity to explore maybe some new genres and to have fun more than anything else, trying different techniques and sticking with, you know, my genre, which is landscape. But it's fun to branch out once in a while. And that may be landscape, but just viewing it differently. And this would be in monochrome. I've also been toying with the idea. I'll have two panels there, and I'll have a number of prints. I might stick something with some really dynamic color right in the center of each of the panels, and then have it surrounded by black and white, just as a kind of a visual teaser. I thought that would be interesting to do. So I'm a very difficult person for you guys to pin down until like the day I bring my prints in, because I haven't quite decided yet what I want to do, but it's going to be primarily monochromatic, and I'm very excited about that.
I like the idea of a splash of color right in the middle. That's an interesting idea.
Yeah.
So you haven't even gotten all of them ready yet. You haven't selected them all or decided what you're going to do. But
I have about probably half of the ones that I'm confident that I'll show, but the other ones I've got a bunch lined up that I'm working on, and that's what's fun. Is I spend my time in the evenings, a lot of evenings, just taking an image and working on it for a while. I'm not someone to do a quick post processing. I'll work on an image maybe for an hour or two some evening. And then I generally, before I show it on social media or display it in a gallery, I'll come back to it two or three times over several days. And I always find something I wish I'd done a little differently. Ultimately, in most cases, each one of my prints is something that I've spent quite a bit of time and thought on. And that's all part of the process that I enjoy. I just happen to have a lot of fun doing that.
Sounds like it. I'm much the same way. You know, I start looking at an image and I say, okay, I've got it. I'm happy with this. Then I come back and look at it later and say, you know what? I need to crop that a little differently. Or, you know what? I need to clone out this thing over here. This is distracting me. I end up fiddling with it. And of course, at some point, you reach a point of no return where you probably are doing more damage than good. I think the wisdom is to know when that point occurs and stop at that point, you know?
I would think most photographers that try to put a little bit of their soul into not only the shoot, but the post-processing, just like you've mentioned, I've also produced a lot of work over the years that long after I've displayed it or I've had it on social media or whatever platform, I'm shaking my head going, why did I ever show that to anyone? So
I get that feeling sometimes myself. So this one that you call Points of Light that you submitted for a preview, is that a sunrise at Letchworth? Is that where you
Yeah, it's just beyond the sunrise. It's, you know, maybe an hour or so after sunrise, but there was a lot of atmosphere that particular morning. So there was haze / fog / mist from the river in the gorge, and you had some dynamic clouds with kind of a silver line, and some of the trees had just starting come out in color, and they stand out more than some of the other ones do. It was just, I thought when I converted that, I thought, holy smokes, it just, I really liked the look of it. It was one of those ones that looked like any other of my gourd shots until I converted it to black and white. And then I put a touch of sepia on it, and that's where the magic happened for me. Mm-hmm. So
how do you do your black and white conversions? Do you use Photoshop, or are you using a plugin like Silver Effects Pro or something like that?
I start everything in Lightroom. I'm in my infancy, actually, with Photoshop. I just dabble in it a little bit. I have the subscription, but I do almost everything in Lightroom, and I'm very excited about expanding my horizons into Photoshop more. It's just a slow process for me, but I start with Lightroom, and then I do use Silver FX Pro.
That's probably the gold standard for black and white conversions, although there's still a lot of programs that will do it.
I'll flip back and forth between that and some of the control I have in Lightroom, and I usually end up with some product that I really like. For me, that's probably the most important goal, is to produce something that I really get a kick out of.
Thank you, Dick, and I hope visitors will come to the gallery to see your photographs and the other photographs we have on display at 722 University Avenue in Rochester.